We let the Lord lead us. We don't.
That's a bit. That's fine.
That's all right.
We just learned this.
I believe that Jesus hung on the cross every night for me.
I knew I'd get there eventually. Wings of Angels. Did you ever do that in Dave? It's kind of a Ralph tune.
You know, I just want to say I love the Lord this evening, and like the brother was talking about earlier, the feeling that you can get whenever you're in church, it's just, there's nothing like it. There's nothing out in the world that compares to it.
Man.
And I don't know what's wrong with people either. I mean, it's everywhere, but you're going to be where you want to be. And, you know, people make all the excuses in the world for not coming out and being in the Lord's house, but, you know, we're not doing God a favor by coming here. We're doing ourselves a favor.
That's right.
By getting to partake of it. Sunday morning, we had such a blessed church service, and we were going to leave and go on vacation right after church service was over with, and I didn't even really want to leave and go anywhere. It was just so good. I just knew that we were, we were just very blessed Sunday morning.
What's that?
Some more people coming in.
Oh, good.
Got some more coming in.
What time is home?
They heard the Lord was here.
They heard this. They heard it. Then.
Yep, heard the Lord was here.
That's right.
Best friend. We're gonna do an old hymn here that saw back in your little maroon, the maroon hymnals you have back there, and I don't remember what page it was on now. It was called Higher Grounds.
Let the banjo man get his cheek going. Are you ready?
Thank you.
I want to tell you how happy we are to have Jim with us right now, because well, it's been about a month.
A little over, maybe a month, yeah.
Put him in the hospital over there, and how many pounds of fluid did they take off?
52
pounds of fluid.
Yeah.
It took off him in about 3 or 4 days?
Yeah, 4 days.
4 days, 52 pounds. Look, now that's not miraculous right
there. That's a miracle right there.
And he looks good, and he feels good, and he's we're just glad to have him.
Even my doctor couldn't believe it.
Yeah.
It's a blessing from the Lord, what it is, because come in, I got a lawn service, come in the other day, I got a little woodshed, you know, there was a woodshed on one end and a smokehouse on the other, and the old smokehouse was going down, the groundhogs were rooted underneath, tore the foundation out of it, and so we tore it down, I took the tractor and tore most of it down, and sawed it down, come in from Moan the other day, and he was up on the roof of that woodshed, patching it, you know, and before, a month before, he couldn't even walk from here to that door back there, and just stopped him, and he was up on the roof, and doing good, so.
I thank God for helping me.
Go ahead, sing.
I'll do it, you sing first.
I promised David that Doug and I would do that song, so we're gonna mess everything up.
Okay.
Blessing.
This one out of
E. Where'd you get them peaches that you got?
South Carolina.
Well, I tell you what, he brought me back about a half bushel of peaches, and I'm telling you, them was good, buddy. They was kind of running right down your chin, you know. Whew, that was good. But thank you for bringing them. Did they pay you for them already?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. You ready?
Sing what I want to sing.
What'd you do, try to destroy it? Get rid of, I don't know the words. Ready?
Yep. Pick something else out to sing, and then they tell me to sing this one, that one. So, but that's one of the first ones we did when we got together and learned, and it's just been a good song to keep with you. You know, the angels are holding up a ladder for you. We climb through this life every day, and it's a challenge from time to time. And you know, we got a better place to come. We got a better place to come. This is just, we're just here for a little while, and we're going through the motions, but. You know, to those that know the Lord, there's a better place coming.
Now, before we get ready to do this song, something that we've been trying to do every place that we go to the last little bit is the request and prayer for our brother in Greenup County, Roger Reed, a funeral director down there at Reed's Funeral Home, and he's got, is it pancreatic? He's got pancreatic cancer, and it's really bad, and they're not giving him a whole lot of hope. But, you know, we serve a God that's capable of doing anything. The same God that raised Lazarus from the dead is the one that we've been praying to. And if you all can just take him on your heart and pray for a miracle, because that's what he needs.
Without him, I could. Without him, I'd surely fail. Without him,
Dave called me this morning. I was out weed eating. He didn't think he was going to be able to sing today. He said that allergy was kind of bothered him pretty bad. But he's more than welcome to jump right in there with us. I don't know where that goes. I'll lay it right there. I don't know where this song
is. You know, I praise God for my little church family. This is all part of my little church family. And I love everyone. It's just like they're my kids, and I love their wives. If they ever told me, Chris, that we couldn't sing with them anymore, we'd just follow them around and come to their houses once a week, hour at a time.
Morning, noon, and night. Is that
dinner? Take turns.
Yeah, okay. We'll try this. We ain't get up here, Joe. Get ready.
I ain't done it for a long time.
It's like him. this song here pretty much says it for me. I found it on a movie. Larry Hogg here finally gave it back to me, or I lost a copy of it. High Lonesome, The Story of Bluegrass. And it was just a little excerpt of this song in that movie. Ralph Stanley is singing it, you know, just a little piece of it. Boy, it just tricked the ear, you know, I loved it. And I looked and looked and finally found the words to it. And Doug did, found the words to it. We'll try it here. I don't know, we ain't done this in a while, but I may not be able to sing like the heavenly angels. I may not be able to preach like Paul. I may not be able to walk on the water like Peter. But I'm willing to try. No, I may not be able to walk
like him.
I may not be able to talk
like him.
I may not be able to preach like Paul. I may not be able to walk
like him.
I may not be able to talk
like him.
But I'm willing. Of Abraham's sacrifice. I may not be able to stand so tall. I may not have the endurance of Moses in the wilderness. But I'm willing to try. No, I may not be able to
like him.
I may not be able to talk
like him.
I may not be able to preach like Paul. I may not be able to walk
like him.
I may not be able to talk
like him.
But I'm willing.